Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to be looking at two separate Mega Construx Destiny sets. On the left, and I will separate these out, over on the left is the EV-30 Tumbler Sparrow set, and on the right we've got all the stuff from the EV-38 Laurelbearer Sparrow set. So first let's look at the Tumbler set. This one gives me a lot of nostalgia because I was actively playing when this first came out, and I still have my original Tumbler from back then. Not many people use it. Every once in a while some of the old schoolers pull it out just for the sake of old schoolness and kind of standing out from the modern racing sparrow crowd. We'll look at the figures separately as usual, but first I want to look at the main build, the Tumbler itself, which looks good. Pretty good print on there. Could have used multiple colors. It's kind of just, you know, in terms of the print itself, it's kind of just orange on top of blue, and it really would have been nice to get more of the gradient in there. But the shaping is good, the overall colors are good. Got the different color for the back of the seat here. And, you know, just in general, I think these are pretty well done. The engine exhausts are looking really good. And this does have a printed console piece, a very small piece that's printed on its smallest side there, which is always nice to see. You can see also up closer a little bit of texture on the forward side pods. That's interesting, just feels interesting. I don't know if it's necessarily a good thing or a bad thing. These are good builds though. Very enjoyable to put together with all of the very small and interesting parts that Mega Construx has, and it does come with the stand. Each of these comes with a stand. So you can lean it over to one side to change up things. You could also rotate this around if you want to do something like this and have it in more of a jumping pose. And of course, Guardian can be posed on there as usual, can be hanging off one side, hold on to just one handlebar. You're not able to really hold on with the feet at all, but just like with the other ones, these do work out pretty well in the end. Nice detail on the underside as well. I might actually choose to leave this piece here off. I feel like it just kind of stands out a little bit much, but one thing that does is allow you to bring this down to the ground. And if you don't have a Guardian on there, then you can just pose it like this, but you can also stick that directly into a plate to just have a pose that's a little bit more believable, a little bit closer to the ground, maybe a little bit too close to the ground, but point is you can use that part to good effect. This Guardian figure is sure to make the Hunter fans happy, and I think that they chose a nice color scheme for this one. It's just a very appropriate color scheme for just the world, the universe of Destiny in general. It's kind of a good representation with a little bit of bright color in there and a lot of muted, earthy and medium to dark tones. I believe this is supposed to be the Beltane shader that this one has on it. And then officially, the weapon there is a Suros ARI-45 or RE-45 auto rifle. Looks like Mega likes their Suros stuff. Not mad at him for it, though. The Ghost Shell is just a green drop. I didn't look up the name of it, but it's just plain black. So it's one of the old, most basic, simple kind. Now, you can consider that to be a Dead Orbit Dread Explorer shell if you want. I would like to use it as a Dread Explorer shell, just pretend. But if Mega wanted to make a Dread Explorer shell, they would have made a Dread Explorer shell. They would have done the two tones, actually the three tones with the extra color there. But this one's just plain. Use it as whatever you want. The cloak is done nicely, printed well. This is a soft, you know, soft, very flexible piece, but the printing stays on there pretty well. And just in general, I feel like this is just a really good representation of a Destiny figure. You know, this one could be kind of used, I think, as their main example for, you know, major graphics or advertisements and stuff. And then the set comes with two of the deceptively large Thrall, one just regular one and one cursed Thrall. I think the one on the left in particular is looking a little bit too yellow and also a little bit too translucent, especially when you just open it up like that. You know, it lets a lot of light through from the back. I really like the cursed ones. The molds are exactly the same. The builds are exactly the same for these. So this is just showing you two potential different poses for essentially the same figure with just a different color on there. For something that has limited articulation, you know, they've got no articulation in the knees or the elbows, that's a good range to be able to get between these two, because they've got the double joints in the shoulder, so you can bring the arms up and down and also in and out across the body like that. And kind of bring it around like this. I mean, that's a really good range. You can hyper-extend the shoulder like that, which is pretty crazy. Yeah, that's a good look. That's a very good look. And this has each of these has the wash on it, which really helps with the appearance. I personally would have gone for a little less saturated color for the plastic, less yellow, you know, a little bit closer to just a beige, like a pale beige or something. But these are not bad, and they are very massable, to be sure. From a set that gave me a good dose of nostalgia, we move to one that gives me very, very little, because this is based on SRL stuff, and I personally have not been able to partake in SRL very much, because the first time it came around was during one of my breaks from the game, and I gotten tired of the grind before new really good content came out, and then the second time around I was too busy making content for this channel to participate. I was only able to run a handful of races. This is the EV-38 Laurelbearer Sparrow itself, which uses some exclusive printed pieces for it to give it its own colors, including this very nice curved piece here on the front, which has a print going across the top of it and also prints on either side. So the top one gives you that orange stripe and then the sides give you the yellow, which then bleeds back or continues back to just the plain yellow colored plastic. So wherever they could, they use just regular plastic pieces. The builds don't vary very much from one to the next, only just as necessary, you know, within a given design of Sparrow, but at least they got it right the first time. This is just a little bit off back here, sorry about that, but just the overall design I think was really good right from the start. So I really feel they don't need to change anything. This is, you know, it's accurate. Of course, the side strakes had to be specialized pieces. There's no way to build that up from you know, non-specialized parts and make it look good in this scale. I think they did a good job. And once again, it comes with the base that allows you to angle things so you can make it go up, down, or side to side. The player of this Titan appears to care about nothing but SRL. Has the full SRL armor set, the crash helmet, SRL shader on, and then for a weapon, didn't even care. This is officially a Nox Umber 1. Green drop, old school, green weapon, uncommon rarity. And, you know, I respect Mega for putting in something that's not great, because not everybody has great stuff. You know, you don't need to put exotic items into every single set. This is cool, but there are so many people who have not even played for that long that run at least legendary gear, at least. So I think there are plenty of legendary fusion rifles that use that exact same mold there that they could have swapped in instead, just in terms of the color scheme. So personally, I think that wasn't the best choice. They could have made more people happy with something else. But then look at this, the Ghost Shell, that's a Skywatch shell. Again, second time, I believe that one's also a green drop. Second time that we've gotten this from Mega. So it's just a basic one. I like the color. I think the color probably would have gone better with the Hunter in the other set. The one thing that I don't like about this figure here is the visor on the helmet. Could have used just a little bit of outline, just a little bit. Something small would have really helped with the edge between the gold, which is great, and the white and the molding of the white, which actually has a good amount of detail in it, but you just don't see the definition between them. Look, paint application on the back of the armor as well. That's nice. It's just missing yellow, I believe, if this is supposed to be the bright laurel SRL shader, which I believe it is. It's just missing yellow. But I think it's pretty clear to see what they were going for overall, and I think that it looks good. I don't mind this. I don't mind the look of it. Just a little nitpick on the helmet, and definitely could have used a slightly higher rarity weapon. Set comes with a Harpy the second time. We've gotten this exact same one in this exact color scheme, and I think this looks pretty good. The marbling in that color combination that Mega does kind of looks like some of the flowing power there. Got the tails that stick out the back, has the stand included, so it's able to pose properly and everything. That's actually pretty nice. I think this is a good thing to get. Once again, pretty massable. That stand does have that extra extension off to one side, which you kind of hide around the back. It gives it more ability to be used in different ways if you're not using it specifically for the Harpy here. But actually, I think the last one wasn't officially supposed to be Harpy, or was it? I think that came with the Atheon set, if I remember correctly. But so it was supposed to be an Oracle, I think. But whatever you want it to be, same mold, and I think it looks good. What I do not think looks good, though, is this Goblin. I think this looks fantastic. This is a beautiful model. It could be a static model, just a display model. It just has the perfect amount of wash on it. The mold is great. All the molds are great. It just practically looks alive. Well, not alive, but you know what I mean. Got the milk the milk bottle that's painted on there. It's actually a pretty shiny part. They tried to make it as bright as possible to make it really stand out. That's good. I appreciate the effort. Exclusive mold, of course, for the weapon. But look at, oh man, the angles. The angle on that neck is really good. Detailing in the legs is good. It's just a shame that here you have no poseability of the knees. Oh man, that would have made it perfect if you could actually squish this down into its deactivated form, you know, just all down close to the ground. So you're not able to do that. But at least there is more articulation in the arms with this one than with the Thrall that we looked at a minute or so ago. Because this one, there we go, it was a little bit stuck because of the wash that's on there, but there we go. That is now loose. This has the joint at the elbow, which has two axes of movement in and out, around. Same thing around the shoulder, up and down, all the way around, in and out, as you wish. And there's also wrist articulation, so you can rotate the hand around like that. And that really helps you with the posing of the weapon, of course, any kind of way. So that's all good. Ball joints for the legs. I will take this off because this is the first time we've seen this particular figure. Ball joints for the legs just in one place. Gives you a decent amount of mobility, but you know, if you're going to put it into a moving pose, then you have to just attach one foot to a studded base down below, and the other one just has to kind of float around. But you know, you can kind of, not really, right? Folding him up, not really, because you want that head to come back. So I really wish they could have done knees here, but I guess they just decided, either for the sake of price or just because of the shape there, more likely because of the shape, I bet. It's generally why they choose not to include joints in certain places, or it's just not physically feasible because it would reduce the durability so much. Head's on a ball joint, so that can do all of the, whoa, sorry about that. The expressiveness that you get actually in-universe, in-game with these things, the different ways that they look around and such. So that's cool. Overall, fantastic figure though. Could have used just one more joint in either leg if that was possible, but even as it is, I love it. I want a bunch of these. So two good Sparrow sets, I think. These actually end up being two of my favorites that they've done so far, just because of the overall inclusion of everything together. You know, I think they present themselves well, and you know, they're always fun to build. It's possible to get these things wrong nonetheless, but I think they've done a pretty good job so far. Little nitpicks here and there, but all told, I am happy. So that does it for my look at these two sets, and I'm definitely looking forward to checking out more as more become available in the future. Speaking of the future, of course, we've got Destiny 2 on the way, and the first of the Destiny 2 specific sets is on the way as well. So stay tuned, and I'll talk to you again as soon as I can.